Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to my class. Today it is about intensive CET NEET JEE class. The topic is dehydration of alcohols. Yesterday we studied about this one in the PU level. The dehydration of alcohol is an example of beta elimination reaction, right? And the beta elimination of dehydration of alcohols is carrying through the formation of a stable carbocation. This is the key point to solve the MCQs regarding CET, NEET, JEE. The topic once again, dehydration of alcohols. Dehydration means removal of water. To remove the water molecule, dehydrating agents are required. In general, to dehydrate the alcohols, concentrated H2SO4 is used. Otherwise, concentrated H3PO4 is used, right? So how the dehydration is going to carry through? Through the formation of stable carbocation. How many carbocations you know? Three types of carbocations. First degree carbocation, second degree carbocation, and third degree carbocation. So whenever three types of carbocations are there, which one is more stable carbocation means third degree carbocation is more stable than second degree carbocation, than first degree carbocation, right? In the last class, we are discussing about butyl alcohol. The general formula of butyl alcohol is C4H9OH. And if I am going to take N-butyl alcohol is represented as CH3, CH2, 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 OH. In this compound, there is no branches present. No branch means normal. Hence, it is written as N hyphen. Four carbons in the chain with hydrogens, with single bonds. That is called as butyl. OH group is called as alcohol. So the common name of the compound is N-butyl alcohol. If we take the IUPAC name, this is the first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, and fourth carbon. So four carbons are there. That is called as but. Between carbon and carbon, single bonds are there. In first carbon having OH. Called as one ol. Butane one ol. Simply it is written as one butanol. So among the four types of butyl alcohols, I am taking one butanol. That is an example of N-butyl alcohol, and that is an example of first degree alcohol. N-butyl alcohol is an example of first degree alcohol. Why? Because means the functional group attached carbon attached with only one carbon. So this is the carbon known as first degree carbon. Hence, N-butyl alcohol or butane one ol or one butanol is an example of first degree alcohol known as primary alcohol. This is an example of primary alcohol. In the last class, we discussed about ethyl alcohol. What is the formula of ethyl alcohol? CH3, CH2, OH is the formula of ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol is also an example of first degree alcohol. Why? Because means functional group attached to carbon, attached with only one carbon. So ethyl alcohol is the first degree alcohol, and one butanol is also the first degree alcohol. Now we are going to consider one butanol dehydration. What is the product of dehydration of one butanol? What is the dehydration product of one butanol? So this is our CET and NEET level topic, dehydration of one butanol. Very important topic. Previous years, the same question is asked in CET and NEET. This is the previous year's question, both from CET and NEET. So I am taking the one butanol, CH3, CH2, 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 OH. Yes, among the four carbons, Which one is the alpha carbon? Which one is the alpha carbon? Functional group attached carbon is the alpha carbon. Functional group attached carbon is the alpha carbon, and its adjacent carbon. This is the carbon adjacent to alpha carbon. So the adjacent carbon of alpha carbon is the beta carbon. So this CH2 carbon is the alpha carbon. This CH2 carbon is the beta carbon. Now we know that here what is happening. What is happening in this reaction? Beta elimination is happening. What is meant by beta elimination? What is meant by beta elimination? Removal of hydrogen from beta carbon. The removal of hydrogen from beta carbon is the beta elimination. So whenever this alcohol is undergoing dehydration, removal of OH minus ion is taking place from alpha carbon, and removal of H plus ion is taking place from beta carbon. So finally, water molecule is going to be removed. So whenever the water molecule is going to be removed, what will be the products? Yes, you have to guess and text me. When it is undergoing dehydration, removal of water molecule, what will be the products? Text me your answer. Guess yourself. What will be the product of dehydration of 1-butanol? What will be the dehydration product of 1-butanol? OH group is removed from alpha carbon. 1 H plus ion is removed from beta carbon. What will be the product of dehydration of 1-butanol? Don't text me as alkene. I know that is an alkene. I'm asking about what is the name of the products. What will be the alkene? Butylene. So what will be the alkene? So many students are saying that butylene. Okay, butylene. Butylene is nothing but butene. Butene. IUPAC name is butene. Butene is again two types. 1-butene is there, 2-butene is there. Once again, 1-butene is there, 2-butene is there. Whether we get 1-butene or 2-butene. During the dehydration of 1-butanol, whether we get 1-butene or 2-butene. Yes, see here. CH2, single bond OH. This is the 1-butanol, okay? First of all, during the dehydration, OH minus ion is removed from, alpha carbon. This is the alpha carbon that is going to lose OH minus ion. Between the carbon and oxygen, the two electrons of the bond is taken by oxygen. The bond is going to be broken between carbon and oxygen. Which type of breaking it is means heterolytic cleavage. Whenever the two electrons of the bond is taken by one atom, that type of cleavage is called as heterolytic cleavage. So due to heterolytic cleavage of carbon-oxygen bond, OH minus ion is going to be removed. Then the alpha carbon gets positive charge. Now it is the beta carbon. This is the beta carbon. Now from the beta carbon, what will be removed? What will be removed? H plus ion will be removed. Suppose I am going to write H2 as CH single bond H. From this one, if the H plus ion is going to be removed, if the bond is going to be migrated between this carbon and carbon, then what we will write? We will write CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH double bond CH2. Four carbons are there. That is butte. First carbon is having double bond, ene. So generally we expect that the dehydration of 1-butanol gives butte 1-ene. But it is not correct. 1-butene is not the product. 2-butene is the product. Here, we are not getting the 1-butene in the reaction. What we are going to get is 2-butene. How it is going to happen? Yes, already I said that the dehydration of alcohols carries through the formation of the dehydration of alcohols carries through the formation of stable carbocations. Once again, the dehydration of alcohols carries through the formation of stable carbocation. Right. Whenever one butanol is undergoing dehydration. What we will get first? First of all, here the body is going to be cleaved between carbon and oxygen. This is the 1-butanol. OH minus ion is going to be removed. What is going to be formed? CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2 plus is going to be formed. This is an example of first degree carbocation. Yes, all of you know first degree carbocations are less stable. And this is the alpha carbon. And this is the beta carbon. Now what is going to happen means, from the beta carbon, one of the hydrogen from beta carbon, including the bond means a H minus ion, because the two electrons of this bond is taken by hydrogen and it becomes as H minus ion is called as hydride ion. So here what is happening means shift of hydride is taking place from beta carbon to alpha carbon. And here we know that alpha carbon is the first carbon, beta carbon is the second carbon. Once again, alpha carbon is the first carbon, beta carbon is the second carbon. What is happening here means 1, 2 shift of hydride is going to happen. That means this hydride H minus is going to be shifted towards alpha carbon. So when the hydride is going to be shifted towards alpha carbon, this carbon, beta carbon, is going to get positive charge, and CH2 becomes CH3. Yes, now you observe, this is the carbon, second degree carbon, and this is an example of second degree carbocation. So during the dehydration of 1-butanol, first of all, it is the formation of first degree carbocation. Then it is going to be rearranged to give the second degree carbocation by 1, 2 shift of hydride. This is going to happen. So finally, what we are going to get? A second degree carbocation is going to be obtained. So whenever second degree carbocation is obtained, now this carbon is taken as the alpha carbon. Carbon with positive charge. This is taken as the alpha carbon. Now the question will arise. This will be the beta carbon, and this also be the beta carbon. So in this case, two types of beta carbons are available. CH2 carbon acting as a beta carbon, as well as CH3 carbon is acting as a beta carbon. Now the question arises. Now the removal of H plus ion. Actually, removal of H plus ion takes place from beta carbon. During the dehydration of alcohols, the removal of H plus ions takes place from beta carbon. But in this case, two types of beta carbons are available. CH3 carbon is the beta carbon, as well as CH2 carbon is the beta carbon. Yes, guess. Now it is your time to guess whether CH2 carbon is going to lose H plus ion, or CH3 carbon is going to lose H plus ion. Now it is your time to guess which type of hydrogen, beta hydrogen, is going to be removed. CH2 hydrogen is removed, or CH3 hydrogen is removed. Whether CH2 hydrogen is going to be removed or CH3 hydrogen is going to be removed. Yes, CH2 hydrogen is going to be removed. From this carbon, what is going to be removed? H plus ion is going to be removed. So when the beta carbon with, this is the beta carbon with less number of hydrogens. Two hydrogens are present at this beta carbon. At this beta carbon, three hydrogens are present. So during the dehydration of alcohols, the beta hydrogen is going to be eliminated. The beta hydrogen is going to be eliminated from the beta carbon with less number of hydrogens. One more thing. This is the beta carbon having methyl group. Whereas this is the beta carbon having no methyl group. This is the beta carbon having no methyl group further. But this is the beta carbon having methyl group. So which type of beta H plus ion is going to be removed means the beta carbon with less number of hydrogens or the beta carbon with more number of substitutes. Once again, the beta carbon with less number of hydrogens or the beta carbon with more number of substitutes, that beta carbon is going to lose H plus ion. Then, yes, guess the product. Guess the product now. So this is the beta carbon is going to lose the H plus ion. This is the beta carbon is going to lose the H plus ion. Now this gets minus charge. When the plus ion is removed, minus charge is obtained. Between the minus and plus, that means bonded electrons are going to be shifted. So finally we will get the product. This is the product. CH3, single bond CH, double bond CH, single bond CH3. So what is the product here? What is the product? 2-butene is the product, but not 1-butene. But not 1-butene. Once again, I'm going to explain the complete mechanism. Just observe carefully. I'm writing all the steps. The concept is dehydration of 1-butanol. Dehydration of 1-butanol. First, step one. I'm writing the step one. What is the step one? What is the step one of dehydration of alcohols? What is the step one of dehydration of alcohols? Step one is the protonation. That means addition of proton. Protonation of alcohol. This is the first step. So protonation. To protonate the alcohol. What is the alcohol taken? What is the alcohol taken? 1-butanol is the alcohol taken. This is the 1-butanol. 1-butanol is the alcohol taken. And this is heated in presence of concentrated H2SO4 at higher temperature. Then, alcohol containing oxygen. The oxygen is going to contain 2 lone pairs. One of the lone pair is donated. One of the lone pair is donated towards H plus ion of concentrated H2SO4. Then, proton. That is H plus ion is going to be added to the alcohol to get the protonated alcohol. To get the protonated alcohol. So here we are getting protonated alcohol. That is protonated. This is the protonated 1-butanol. Right? This is the step one. So in the first step, what we are getting? Protonated alcohol is the formation in the first step. Just take the screenshot. So during the dehydration of alcohols, step one is the protonation of alcohols, means addition of proton to the alcohol to form the protonated alcohol. That is the step one. Right? Now, coming to step two. Step two. In the step two, during the step two, dehydration of protonated alcohol. The step two is the dehydration of protonated alcohol to form stable carbocation. To form stable carbocation. This is the step two. Formation of a stable carbocation by the dehydration. So protonated alcohol is taken, CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH2 single bond, O single bond H, oxygen with positive charge. Now, here between carbon and oxygen, the two electrons of the bond, the two electrons of the bond is taken by oxygen. Bond is going to be broken between carbon and oxygen. Removal of water molecule is going to take place. Removal of water molecule, H2O is going to be removed to form the carbocation. First of all, we are going to get primary carbocation. CH3, single bond, CH2, single bond, CH2, single bond, CH2 plus. Here it is. CH3, single bond, CH2, single bond, CH2, single bond, CH2 plus. So initially, in the step two, initially we are getting, in the step two, initially we are getting first degree carbocation. But we know that first degree carbocations are, first degree carbocations are less stable. The first degree carbocations are less stable. As a result, to form the more stable carbocation, 1, 2 shift of, 1, 2 shift of hydride. Hydride means H minus ion is called as hydride. So 1, 2 shift of hydride ion takes place. Takes place to give stable carbocation. To give the stable carbocation. So this is going to happen. That is the rearrangement. Rearrangement of the cation is going to happen. And the reaction is CH2, single bond, CH2 plus. This is the first degree carbocation. And it is going to get rearranged. And this is the alpha carbon. This is the beta carbon. So this beta carbon containing hydrogen removed as H minus ion. And that H minus ion is going to be bonded to CH2 plus. Then CH2 plus becomes as CH3. Thus CH2 becomes as CH plus. Then CH3 single bond. CH2 single bond. Thus CH2 becomes as CH plus. Why it is CH plus? Because this beta carbon is going to remove, or the beta carbon is going to lose H minus ion. Then CH2 becomes as CH plus. And the removed H minus ion is going to be bonded to CH2 plus. Then CH2 plus becomes as CH3. Now you observe, two types of carbocations are there here. This is the first degree carbocation. First degree carbocation. This is the second degree carbocation. Which one is more stable among the first degree carbocation and second degree carbocation? Which one is more stable? Yes, second degree carbocation is more stable. The second degree carbocation is more stable. Now this second degree carbocation is going to react with the water molecule in the third step. So this is about second step. The second step is the dehydration of protonated alcohol to form a stable carbocation. Initially, we are taking protonated alcohol, that is protonated 1-butanol, on heating, removal of water molecule is going to take place to form the N-butyl carbocation. That is the first degree carbocation is formed and it is less stable. So to get the more stable carbocation, what is happening means 1, 2 shift of hydride ion is going to take place. What is meant by 1, 2 shift? Because here this carbon is taken as first carbon. This carbon is taken as the second carbon. From the second carbon, H minus ion is called as hydride ion is going to shift from second carbon to first carbon. Then second carbon is going to get positive charge. See here, this is the second carbon going to get positive charge to give a more stable carbocation. So once again, the step two in the dehydration of alcohols is dehydration of protonated alcohols to form a stable carbocation. Let's take the screenshot. Step 2 is the formation of more stable carbocation. So sometimes to form the more stable carbocation, what is going to happen? To form the more stable carbocations, what is going to happen in the step 2? Sometimes there is a shift off, 1, 2 shift off, hydrodance is going to take place to form the more stable carbocations. Yes, coming to step 3. In the step 3, what are going to react? Yes, in the step 2, what is formed? In the step 2, what is formed? More stable carbocation is formed. That is the second degree carbocation is formed. Now in the step 3, attack of water molecule as nucleophile. Attack of water molecule as nucleophile onto the more stable carbocation. Attack of water molecule as nucleophile onto the more stable carbocation. So in the second step, what is the more stable carbocation formed? This is a more stable carbocation formed. This is named as secondary butyl alcohol. This is the butyl group. This total one is called as butyl group. And this is the second degree carbon. So this ion is called as second degree carbocation. That is the second degree or secondary butyl carbocation. So this second degree butyl carbocation or secondary butyl carbocation. The secondary butyl carbocation, CH3, CH2, CH plus, single bond CH3 is going to attacked by water molecule as nucleophile. Water molecule as nucleophile. This is the water molecule. The water molecule is acting as a nucleophile. And the water molecule is going to absorb beta hydrogen. The water molecule is going to absorb beta hydrogen. Yes, once again, this is the alpha carbon, this is the beta carbon, and this is the beta carbon. Which beta carbon is going to lose H plus ion? CH2 carbon is going to lose H plus ion because it is going to give more stable alkene. So now if you observe the CH2, I'm writing CH2 as CH single bond H. This is the beta carbon. This beta carbon with 2 hydrogens. This is the beta carbon with 3 hydrogens. So which beta carbon is going to lose means? The beta carbon with less number of hydrogens is going to lose H plus ion. And this lone pair is going to be donated towards H plus ion. This bonded electrons are shifted between carbon and carbon to give the alkene. So finally, we will get alkene. What is alkene? CH3, single bond CH. Single bond becomes double bond CH. Single bond CH3. Yes, this is the product obtained, and the name of the product is 2-butene. 2-butene. Yes, this is the final product. Take the screenshot. Yes, my dear students, you will get a doubt. Sir, suppose this beta carbon is going to lose H plus ion, what will happen? That is our question. Next question. When the beta carbon with more number of hydrogens is going to lose H plus ion, what will happen? Yes, observe here. Again, step 3 in a different format. In the step 3, what are going to react? In the step 3, what are going to react? A carbocation is going to be, in the step 3, generally what is going to happen? Carbocation is going to be attacked by water molecule. Here, the water molecule is acting as a nucleophile. This is the step 3 of dehydration of alcohols. Once again, carbocation. Our carbocation is second degree carbocation. That is the secondary butyl carbocation. This is the second degree carbon, and the ion is called as secondary butyl carbocation. This is the stable carbocation. This is the stable carbocation formed in the step 2. This one is the stable carbocation formed in the step 2. When water molecule is going to react, when the water molecule is going to react, water molecule is going to react and the lone pair is going to be shifted. Now this is the beta carbon, and of course this is the beta carbon. This is the beta carbon with 3 hydrogens. This is the beta carbon with 2 hydrogens. Now the beta carbon with more number of hydrogens, is going to lose H plus ion. CH3 is written as CH2 single bond H, the lone pair of electrons. The lone pair electrons of oxygen of water donated towards beta carbon with more number of hydrogens. Then this bond is going to be shifted between carbon and carbon. Yes, what will be the product now? What will be the product? CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH single bond becomes double bond. Double bond, CH2. Yes, the compound is called as 1-butene. 1-butene. So here two possibilities are there. In the step 3, when the carbocation is going to be attacked by water molecule, which type of carbocation is attacked? When the stable carbocation is attacked by water molecule, removal of H plus ion can take place. Removal of H plus ion can take place from beta carbon with less number of hydrogens. As well as beta carbon with more number of hydrogens. But what is the main thing happening means removal of H plus ions from beta carbon with less number of hydrogens is going to happen to give the more stable product. Yes, once again, take the screenshot. My dear students, in the step three, how many products are obtained? When the beta carbon with less number of hydrogens is going to lose H plus ion. Yes, what is the product obtained? The product obtained is CH3 single bond, CH double bond, CH single bond, CH3. This is the product obtained. The name of the product is 2-butene is the name of the product. And one more thing has happened. Whenever beta carbon with more number of hydrogens is going to lose. When the beta carbon with more number of hydrogens is going to lose H plus ion. Yes, what is the product obtained? The product obtained is CH3 single bond, CH2 single bond, CH double bond, CH2. And the name of the product is 1-butene. So during the dehydration of 1-butanol, how many types of products are going to be obtained? Two types of products are going to be obtained. One is the 2-butene, second one is the 1-butene. Yes, can anybody guess which one is the symmetrical alkene? This is also the alkene. Among this one and this one, which one is the symmetrical alkene? 2-butene and 1-butene, which one is the symmetrical alkene? Waiting for your response. Which one is the symmetrical alkene? Whether 2-butene or 1-butene, which one is symmetrical alkene? Yes, 2-butene is the symmetrical alkene. Symmetrical compounds are more stable. Once again, symmetrical compounds are more stable. So which is going to be the major products? Which is going to be the major products during the dehydration of 1-butanol? Which one is going to be the major product? Means 2-butene is going to be the major product. How it is going to form? Because of the loss of H plus ions from beta carbon with less number of hydrogens. So here our concept is, during the dehydration of alcohols, the removal of H plus ion from beta carbon takes place from the beta carbon with less number of hydrogen atoms, but not from beta carbon with more number of hydrogen atoms. Once again, the elimination of H plus ion from beta carbon takes place from the beta carbon with less number of hydrogens, but not from beta carbon with more number of hydrogens. So this is about today's topic. If you understood, please text me in the chat box. If you understood the topic, please text me in the chat box. If you didn't understood, please watch the recorded video once again. Please watch the recorded video once again. And if you are having any doubt, please don't text me. You can call me between 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. Don't text me. You can call me between 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. If you understood my topic, please text me in the chat box. Whether you understood or not, please text me in the chat box. And it is the most important topic. Same question is asked in our previous CET and NEET